What's up, guys? Welcome back to another episode of Gaming with the Wolfpack. In this episode, we're on WrestleMania in my GM mode. Mo, it's time for Mania of the Wrestle. You know what I wish we was able to do?
What?
Come out and cut a promo on ourselves.
You ain't lying.
Your first two matches should have been switched.
They still a good job, though.
Yeah, but your main card must be worse than your opener. It don't make no sense, though, because the first time we put them two girls together, they gave you dull.
I know, they were just sucking.
If you ever need a reminder that superstars in the WWE are the toughest competitors in all of sports entertainment, tables match will do it.
What some fans don't realize is that the pain in these matches usually comes before the finale, when they're using the table as a weapon or a torture device.
I definitely don't envy anyone in a tables match.
I'm glad the only table I have to deal with is our announce table right here.
Strong form.
Nail it by Nakamura. Look out.
Oh, axe kick. First one missed. Second one didn't. Effective.
Hart gets out of there.
Trampling.
Oh, the arm's trapped.
Oh, and a slam.
Nakamura was ready for that one.
That'll pop some teeth.
Grinded him down a little.
Yeah, Cole, but he's just focused on avoiding going through the table. That's all that matters. Big impact off the leg drop.
Slips out of the way there. What reflexes?
Taking this outside. This could be good.
Nakamura said he need a brush. Bret Hart tan him up. That's what he said. He said, I need to take a break.
What's he hoping to find down there?
A steel chair? Something we all know to be a devastating weapon.
Down with the leg drop. The King of Strong Style is being dismantled.
Hitman working the competition down.
And a running knee lift.
Oh, I heard a snap.
Inflicting more damage to the leg.
Bret was waiting for it.
Quick reaction to Hart there. Able to give him the slip.
Ooh. Oh man, what a leg drop.
We have Bret Hart on the defensive. Right, knee left.
He's looking to take this fight to a whole new level. There he goes, right into the corner.
Oh, right to the kidney.
One time come back. Ooh.
Blocks the boots, connects to the back of the neck.
High speed, sliding turn.
He's back into the ring. Nakamura looking to go airborne. Perched up top. Oh, a huge miss there. Elbow lands home. Now pull the hair into a mat slam.
It's the way that was gonna work.
Whoa.
This is the type of victory where you really have to weigh the costs against the benefits.
It was okay. It was okay.
Nakamura did good on your show. He just bringing victory after victory.
One, two, three.
Oh, it's time for the main event.
Introducing the challenger from San Diego, California, Nia Jax. And introducing the champion from Dublin, Ireland, the Raw Women's Champion, Becky.
The highly sought out Raw Women's Championship. I can honestly tell you there's only one question on these women's minds right now. Who will walk out of here? The face of WWE's flagship women's division?
of how bad she wants to stay in this match.
Right by those cell walls. Oh, the reversal by Becky Lynch. Oh, what an uppercut. So impactful. Gets inside the ring.
That's what I'm saying. She is really fighting for it.
Absolutely. You love to see someone's determination come to fruition like this.
You should have took your opener and put it in the middle and put that mid card in the opener. Your night would have been perfect. For my champion. I kind of want to watch this, but I want to watch that one too. Which match do you want to watch?
One, two, three.
The following contest is a Hell in a Cell match and is for the WWE Universal Championship. Introducing the challenger from Death.
The top title of WWE's flagship brand, the Universal title, is on the line right now. Lesnar, Goldberg, Reigns, Rollins, some big names have made this title prestigious and sure, gentlemen. Somehow we saw Taker coming. Dangerous area inside the cell.
It's a table. I'm not sure what he's scheming, but it can't be good.
Ooh. Oh, jarring uppercut.
Look, this is Hell in a Cell. The hurting has only just begun for him.
He's heading back to the ring. For the title.
One, two,
a kick out before three.
That was a long two count there.
Might be starting to set in.
Oh my gosh, the lights are out. They're back on. Look behind you.
Definitely not where you want to be right now. Just carried like a rag doll here. Tough position to be caught in here. Locked face first.
What a shot.
Got him set up in the corner of the ring. Knew it was coming from Taker. Up and loaded. Nice takedown. Has the challenger pinned. Is this it? Kick out of that.
He is certainly sending a message, getting his shoulder up before two.
Neckbreaker. Ah, look at this.
So much damage inflicted.
Undertaker moves just in time. The champ looking out of sorts.
This is what you expect from Hell in a Cell. Nobody makes it out without having to endure their share of suffering.
Turning the tables.
Backbreaker. Good grief.
Just carrying the opposition anywhere they want. Boom, what impact! Out of the ring and even closer to the chain link enclosure. Oof. Solid punch. Boom! Ooh! Undertaker counters.
Undertaker is just doing whatever he wants now.
Now's a chance for him to get back into this match.
Ooh! Big overhand. Unloading with an uppercut. Oh.
Reversed. As we all know, Hell in a Cell matches tend to deteriorate once the competitors leave the confines of the ring. Inside.
The dead man lining up his next victim moments away.
Popped up, no way. Yes way.
What power.
Peace. The title's in jeopardy here.
I think the paradigm has shifted.
One, two count. Near fall.
What a display of stamina. The champ showing their true.
What power. Champ's eyes look glazed over.
Looking for the victory.
Two. And we have a new champion. Unbelievable.
Here is your winner and the new WWE Universal Champion, The Undertaker.
A night and title change we will all remember for a very long time.
To go from challenger to champion, that has to feel good.
unless you're the one going from champion to nothing.